My talk today is about the, our database, microbiome database. And I would like to introduce a new protocol for constructing this database. And this graph shows the growth of the microbiome data stored in our database, MBGD. The number it increased recently because of the new sequence technology, the data is increased very rapidly, and the most important part is here, the difference between the number of genomes and the number of species, which correspond to the number of genomes that is overlapped with some, at least one species, or the difference between the number of genomes and the number of genus, number of genera, increased more and more. This indicates that the genome data of closely related species or genomes are increased more and more. On the other hand, the number of higher taxonomic rank are still increasing gradually. This is because probably partly because number of genome sequences obtained from the probably the metagenomic analysis obtained from the various environment samples that increase also increase higher level taxonomic levels, and we developed a database for microbiome comparison named MBGD. This database was established almost 20 years ago, and now this database contains almost 5,000 genomes, and includes this database includes bacteria and archaea and unicellular eukaryotes. I would like to introduce this database briefly. The main contents of this database is orthologous relationships among the microbes. And the default data, default orthog table, or we call the standard orthog table, covers the entire taxonomic range. This database was created by using the standard genome set, which contains one genome from genus, from each genus. And here is a eukaryote, and here is a bacteria, and this table continues beyond the end of the display. And anyway, so this is the default table that covers the entire taxonomic range. But in addition to this table, we also provide taxonomy-specific orthog tables for each taxa. Users can choose any taxon from here and you see the orthologous table specifically in this taxa. In this case, I show the strains of Helicobacter pylori. And in this kind of a comparison, this kind of comparison is more and more important because the number of genome sequences available is more and more increasing. And typically, for this kind of analysis, one can see the so here is a histogram shows a histogram showing the number of strains included in each orthologous group. So here is a orthologous group conserved in all of the strains. Usually called this a core genome. And here is the other side. This is correspond to the strain-specific genes. And the entire orthologous groups correspond to the entire repertoire of this species. Usually called this called pangenome. And this kind of analysis is very common. And we also, this is an example of such analysis by ourselves. This is a comparison of Helicobacter pylori. And the important thing is that pattern of the conservation among the intermediate cases here. So we classify orthogous groups according to the similarity of the occurrence patterns. And also we use the chromosomal location, proximity, to make a groups of orthogous groups. And this kind of analysis can identify the many of the genomic islands. So like this. So by this approach, you can identify many kinds of the new genomic islands. Okay. And also, I would like to introduce another feature of our database is the orthology identification method. In this database, we consider not only orthogous relationships are not at the gene level, but the domain level. So when the domain fusion event occurs, we split fused genes into different domains, like this. So this kind of analysis is one of the important feature of our database. And for this purpose, we developed two programs. One is a DomCLUST, which is a hierarchical clustering algorithm. This is based with domain splitting. This algorithm uses similarity, all against similarity relationship calculated by BLAST. And then we refine the result of the domain splitting using the multiple sequence alignment. This program is named the DomRefine. We combine these programs to make an orthogous classification. And overall procedure, current overall procedure constructing MBGD is shown here. So this is a very complex procedure, but main part is here. Main part is shown here. This is a standard also table, and this table is created from the representative organism taken from one genome from each genus, and using the DomCLUST and DomRefine. And also we prepared a taxon-specific also table. And actually we also, not only the complete genome, but also the draft genome sequence can also be incorporated into our database. Actually the picking the unique genus, belonging to the unique genus are added to the standard ORSOG table and create draft plus ORSOG table. And also MBGD allow user to submit user genomes to add their genome sequences into the ORSOG tables. But here I would like to focus on this part. So by simplifying this protocol, we focus on this part of the construction procedure. This is a previous procedure. For standard ORSOG table, we use a representative genome for each genus. And also we prepare the taxon-specific ORSOG table. For example, the genus-specific ORSOG table, we choose a representative genome for each species, and then create a genus level. And the species level, we use all genomes belonging to the species level. This is a current previous procedure. The problem of this procedure is there are two problems. First problem is the comprehensiveness. Because we choose a representative genome before creating the ORSOG table, so then the standard ORSOG table contains only the genes that are contained in the representative genomes. So thus it might lost some information. Genes are not included in the representative genome. This is one problem. And another problem is the efficiency. So if you consider only the standard ORSOG table, then the calculation cost is very low. But we also consider the within genus and within species. And actually, we calculate all against all similarity search, maintain the all against all similarity search in the MBGD. In this case, the computation cost is very large because so many species, the genome of the same species, the genome of the same genus. Calculating all against all similarity is very time consuming. So this is another problem. So to overcome these problems, we modify the procedure like this. So this is called, so we consider the pan-genome based orthologous clustering. So in this case, the procedure is stepwise manner. So first we create the orthologous table within species orthologous table. In this case, all genome data belonging to each species are input, and then create the orthologous table, then select representative gene from each orthologous group, and then create the pan-genome of each species. And then this is input of the next step, and then we create a genus-level orthologous table, and then select the representative gene from each OG, and then this, and make, create a pan-genome in a at the genus level. And then this data is the input of the next step. And finally, we create a standard orthologous table covering the entire taxonomic range. So this is a schematic illustration of the this stepwise protocol. So this is the previous version. In the previous version, we create each orthologous table independently by choosing the representative genome beforehand. But the new protocol create orthologous tables in a stepwise manner. First, you create a orthologous table in a species level, and then create a pan-genome, and then the next create a genus level orthologous table, and then create a pan-genome, and then the standard create also standard also table. So the problem, one problem here is how to select the representative gene from each genus. So because our database considers a domain level also classification, so the length of the gene is important. So the gene should be covered and correspond to the original domain length. This is a desirable criteria. So for this purpose, we consider these conditions. So first, eliminate partial domain genes are eliminated. And also the split genes, two short genes, also eliminated. And also, we consider the we check the median of the length and eliminate genes that have a high far distance from this median length. And also, we check the similarity among the genes because we consider also clustering method uses the hierarchical clustering. So we have a hierarchical clustering tree, and using this tree, we can identify the outlier of the genes and eliminate such genes. Then, and the remaining one, from the remaining genes, we pick the one genome. In this case, we use a species weight criteria. Species weight means this is criteria same as picking the representative genome in the previous procedure. How to weight the species is currently a very simple criteria. We use a simple criteria. Release date. Earlier release genome has a higher weight. This simple criteria, we use this kind of simple criteria. Anyway, so using this criteria, we can expect that many of the majority of the genes are extracted from one highest one genome that has the highest species weight. So this is a criteria for selection of representative genes. And then once this procedure is completed, we have a species level ortho group and the genus level ortho group and the standard ortho table. And using all of these data, you can expand the clustering results, extend the pan-genome data to contain all of the genomes included in each genus or species. So then you can recover the entire gene set from this kind of procedure. One complexity remains, which is a domain boundary problem, because our database considers a domain level also clustering. We should assign the domain boundary for each assignment. And for this problem, we consider the representative genes, the domain boundary of the representative genes. Using this information, we can reconstruct this domain boundary for any other genes. And we implemented this procedure and create a next version of MVGD. So this is an example. Here is a standard ortho table, and clicking some genes from the pan genome, then you can expand here. So in this case, the bacillus, a genus bacillus specific ortho tables. And this is a this table shows the number of pan genomes for each the top 10 number of genomes, highest top 10 highest number of genomes in species level and the genus level. And so we in the current this is actually the previous version, current version, not the next version. But so anyway, these kind of data are already accumulated. And so this is the total number of genes. And when creating the pan genome, then the size is reduced to this. So we can use this information to create a species and the genus level pan genomes, ortholog tables. And this is a this table shows the size of the final standard ortho tables. So this is a previous version, which uses only the representative genome set. And this is a new version, using the pan genome data set. And the number of sequences included in the orthogous group is increased almost 25%. And because of that, the number of clusters increased more, almost 70% larger than the previous version. So this means that actually the smaller sizes of clusters are increased more, and then the cluster size increased more. So and we should also note that the total sequences included in the database is 4 times larger than the this number. But basically, if we expand the, this sequences, this sequence includes a gene from the pan genome. So we can expand this data set, and all of these sequences can be assigned to any of these clusters. And this graph shows a number of genus included in the orthogous groups. And here is the previous version, and here is the new version. And as I mentioned, new version, especially the orthogous groups having the smaller size, more increased. And possibly these smaller orthogous group correspond to the non-core genes. Genes are not conserved in the species or genus, but conserved in different genus. So such genes, there are a lot of such genes. Such genes are lost in a previous version of our database because we pick only the representative genes. But when we consider the pangenome, all pangenome, we can pick classify all of these genes. So this is another analysis. So in this analysis, we make correspond between the genus level orthologue table and the species level orthologue table, and correspondence between the conservation ratio. So the and here, so the majority of the genes are conserved, very conserved genes are here. So both genus level and the species level, these genes are conserved, perfectly conserved. And some, these genes are unique genes, probably unique genes. These genes are not conserved, both genus and species level. And these genes are conserved in the species level, but not the genus level. So these genes are species-specific core genes. And there are a lot of other genes. And I think these genes can be extracted. Most of the newly identified orthogous group correspond to such genes. Hi. And these genes, basically we consider that these genes are environment-specific genes and also the mobile genetic element, et cetera, and mainly horizontally transferred. So our new version of the database can include these genes, and our database can be used to analyze these kind of data. And this is my collaborator. This person is involved in the development of MBGD. Thank you very much.